Today, we are gonna fix Photoshop generative fill not showing problem. Before moving on to the video, don't forget to leave a like. As you can see, the generative fill feature is currently not showing. The reason for this is the version of Photoshop beta we are using. The solution is to update Photoshop beta. To do this, we go to the search section and open Adobe Creative Cloud. After that, click on beta apps. Then, click on the three dots next to Photoshop beta and select uninstall. At this point, Adobe will ask if we want to remove our preferences as well. If you don't want your preferences to be deleted, click on keep. Wait for Photoshop beta to be uninstalled. We have uninstalled Photoshop beta. Now, on the left side, click on updates. Then, click on check for updates. This step is important, because the generative fill feature is introduced in the latest update. Once the check is complete, either Photoshop beta will appear here or in the beta apps section. As I mentioned before, we must perform the check for updates in order to download the latest version of Photoshop beta. After clicking on the beta apps, proceed to install Photoshop beta. We are currently downloading the latest version of Photoshop beta. After the installation process is complete, click on the three dots next to open and select other versions. The version we downloaded should be 24.6. The generative fill feature is not available in older versions. The reason for performing the check for updates was to access this update. Now, we click on open and check if the feature is available in Photoshop. I choose an image from my computer to show as an example for the video. As you can see, a notification confirming that the generative fill feature is available. When we select a part of our image, we can use the generative fill feature. After clicking on generative fill, click on agree. The next step is to type what we want in this bar. Once we have done that, we click on generate. It generated our image. We can also see other variations. If we are not satisfied with the result, we can select the generative layer on the right side and press the delete key to remove it. We have come to the end of the video. I hope this video was useful for you. If the video helped you, don't forget to like the video. You can also subscribe to my channel to support me. Take care and see you in the next video.